Hello.
Hi there. Today we'll just have a short video for you on switch control on iOS, in this case on an iPhone. And we have some new extensions as well. So let's dive in. You will need a PC with the Microsoft Accessory Center to configure your inputs there first before moving to your iOS device. Learn more about how to do this in our Fundamentals video. The key is to assign unique input to each of the switches you want to use. In this case, we will start with adding key combination 1 to port 1 and key combination 2 to port 2 of the hub. In addition to setting up short press, we're also adding unique characters to long press for port 1 and port 2. And in the same way, we will go through the setup for the D-pad used in this video. Simply define a unique character per input you want to use on your iOS device. Once you've configured everything you want to use, let's move over to the iPhone. To connect the Microsoft Adaptive Hub to the iPhone, I'm using this USB-A to Lightning adapter. But if you have a newer iPhone or iPad model with USB-C, the standard USB-C to USB-C cable will do. For switch control on iOS, make sure not to connect over Bluetooth. You can, however, with assistive touch. Check out our previous video for that. Let's go into settings and find the accessibility tab. And under accessibility, let's select switch control and toggle it on. Let's plug in two external switches into port 1 and port 2. Click on switches. Add new switch, external, click the first switch and name it, next in this case. And I'll set the move to next item command to it. I'll then go and repeat these steps and add a long press functionality for the same button. Make sure to configure the long press in the Microsoft Accessory Center on your PC first, otherwise you'll get a button conflict. I'll go ahead and add select item to my long press. Next, I will go and add functionality for the second switch I have. And I'll go ahead and add the escape functionality to it. Finally, for this setup with two switches, let's add a long press functionality for the second switch as well. In this case, the functionality to open the scanner menu. So now we have a simple navigation setup for your iPhone, but quite obviously there's a vast variety of different ways to set this up. Especially if you have the ability to use more switches, you can go up to 5 external switches, which you can obviously multiply with long press and different profiles. Now I can obviously also use the Microsoft Adaptive Buttons, which then allow me to actually wirelessly connect to my hub. And the adaptive buttons can obviously be combined with the external switches already set up with the hub. For now, I'm just showing you one adaptive D-pad button here. I'll set the D-pad up button to move to previous item. I'll then go ahead and add the D-pad down button and assign the move to next item to it. And I will repeat this process for the D-pad right button, in this case to select an item. And same as setting up long press for the external switches through the hub, you can do the same for the D-pad if you wanted to, as long as you configure the long press in the Microsoft Adaptive Accessory Center before. In addition to long press, profiles can also be used for both the external switches and the adaptive buttons to further multiply input. Here you see me configuring the D-pad up button again, so this is the third time. Once for short press, once for long press, and I'm now configuring it for profile 1. And remember that you have an additional 2 profiles to configure. For demo purposes, I'm assigning increased volume to the D-pad up button in profile 1. So going back to profile 0, the D-pad simply allows me to navigate. But switching back to profile 1, The D-pad up button allows me to increase volume. Remember that changing profiles can be done on the hub, but also with an external or adaptive button. The D-pad itself already offers a lot of input options, so let's assign a few more. D-pad left to open the scanner menu, and D-pad top left for escape. I now have quite a nice navigation mechanism with this one D-pad. I'm only using a few of its functionalities, but you can obviously design it completely to your preferences. Maybe add a trigger for voice, and being able to control your smart home through the phone, this can offer a lot of opportunities. Remains are showing you this new base plate that you can use with larger toppers. So if you're increasing your hit area and also want to lower your force of fire, for example, these larger toppers can be interesting. And this base plate allows you to create a more solid base for these larger toppers. And finally, if you want to mount your button with a 1/4-inch screw solution, we also have a 3D printed piece for that. Make sure to check them out in the Shapeways marketplace. You can download the files there for free or order the parts through shapeways.com.
We are finished. See you next time. Bye.
Bye.